This is a life lesson that all of us need to learn. Never piss off Maggie Smith.
Or she gonna kill ya.
Peeping Mom, released in 2005 and is directed by Neil Johnson, who has also directed such films like The Big Swap, The Ghost of Greville Lodge, Mom's List, and The Stolen. And this film is starring Kristin Scott Thomas, Rowan Atkinson, Tamsin Edgerton, Patrick Swayze, and the magnificent Maggie Smith. And the reason why we're talking about Peeping Mom today is because it was a PayPal recommendation and donation from one of my contributors and supporters of this channel, James Filbury. I believe this is the last film in your little bundle that you sent me. Thank you very much for your support. If any of you out there want to be like James and help support me and contribute to this channel, you can click on the PayPal link that is on the homepage of my YouTube channel. Any size donation will do, and you can attach your movie recommendation with your donation. And if I have access to it, I will watch it, review it, and give you a shout out, just like what I did with James Filbury here. And James, one of these movies that I have never even heard of before. This is a nice little British comedy, and it's absolutely delightful. Like, this is one of my favorite films I have watched this year. The Goodfellows seem like they would be a nice, loving family, but everyone feels disconnected with each other. Holly is getting older and exploring her sexuality with different boys. Petey is being picked on and bullied at school, and Gloria and Walter are struggling to find that passion between each other. So Gloria starts seeing her golf instructor, Lance, played by Patrick Swayze. Which, gosh, I mean, that would just be hard not to jump on him, you know, if he was your golf instructor. Well, I guess it would be hard now because he's dead, but, you know. But in comes the brand new housekeeper, Grace Hawkins, who is trying to set everyone straight and rekindle the love that this family has for each other. It just so happens, though, she may go about it by killing people who try to interfere in the family business. And I think that's amazing. And I think it only works because it's Maggie Smith. If we would have gotten anyone else in this role, I don't think this movie works. But because it's Maggie Smith, and we all know Maggie Smith from just lovable, matronly-like roles like in Sister Act and in the Harry Potter films, she has that quality of nurturing and comfort and really having like a motherly air about her that whenever she's in, you just feel comfortable and you feel good. You feel like you're being taken care of because she is in your living room. Or she is in your kitchen baking you a pie. Like, that's just, she's lovely. She is wonderful. So to turn her into a serial killer, but with good intentions, is one of the most brilliant ideas I have ever heard of. And she is great. She is lovely. I don't think this is anything different than what we've seen of Maggie Smith. But because this is Maggie Smith, it just works. It is perfect. She never yells. She never raises her voice. She is always calm. She is always stoic. She is always in command of the situation. Maggie Smith is one of these people, and also this character of Grace Hawkins is just one of these people that you know that they have lessons, and you know that they have advice that you want to hear and that you want to take in and absorb. Because every time she does, it turns out right. She gives the suggestion to the Reverend, like, hey, your sermons, they're a bit of a drag. Why not use a couple of jokes? That is how you can enter people's minds and people's hearts and then convey your serious message with them. She sees that there's something up with Gloria and then her golf instructor, and she wants to set that right because she should be madly in love with her husband. And then how she helps little Petey with his school bullies, I think that is great. I think that's inspiring. Sometimes people just need a slap across the face, or in her case, you know, your brake lines cut on your bicycle. It teaches you a lesson without really hurting you. However, there are moments in here, and Filbury, I know that you recommended this movie just because of this one aspect. You're like, oh, this is gonna get under Caleb's skin, and it did. There is a barking dog that causes Gloria not to be able to sleep for the first part of this movie, and then when Maggie Smith comes in, with Grace Hawkins comes in, she hears the dog barking and goes out and takes care of the dog. Didn't like that. Didn't like that, James. What are you doing? I almost turned it off. Like, no. You can train the dog. You can take the dog in for your own, or you can let the dog into the house, or you can kill its master because he was just letting that dog out there all night being cold and frozen. Don't kill the dog, but you killed the dog. God damn it. I don't like seeing cat or dog deaths on screen, or I don't even like it being implied. It sucks. I don't like it. But this movie turned out to be great. So I'm putting that aspect aside, damn it. It does end up being great, and a great little British comedy. British comedy, they're hit and miss with me. Some of them, most of them land with me. Some of the ones, though, are just complete misses, and I just don't understand, or I'm just not grasping what's going on. But here, everything was landing with me. Maybe it's because where I'm at in my life, I'm older, oh my gosh, I'm 35 now, so I'm kind of in that kind of midlife area where things like this are going to be aspects that I'm going to be dealing with, or ideas of like rekindling love or things like that. I also love the advice that she gave the Reverend about the little prose or one of the lines that are in the Bible, and he's talking about like, no, it's a devotion, it's a love song to God. And Hawkins is like, no, this little song, this little poem, this is about sex. This is about this character wanting to get down and get freaky. And then to hear Rowan Atkinson sensually read this Bible verse, like, very erotically, like, it was kind of working for me. What is written down and how he was delivering it was, that was good. Like, I almost picked up a Bible and started reading it again just to see if there were any other obvious sexually undertoned things in there that I wasn't picking up when I was a kid and I was actually into that stuff. The Bible is sexier and is smuttier than I thought it was, so good for you, Christians. You got it going on. Keeping Mom is a delightful comedy. It kind of wraps itself up with a nice little pretty bow at the end, which, I don't know, it kind of just seemed like, oh, yes, great goody-goody two-shoes type ending. That's the only, like, criticism I can give it, though. Everything else is just delight seeing the growth in these characters and the rekindling of love with this entire family between the husband and wife and then the parents and the children. Just became a happy little family, and I loved it. I'm gonna give Keeping Mom 4.5 out of 5 Blu-rays.
It's good. It's good.
So guys, if you've seen Keeping Mom, what did you think about it? Or if you've never seen it before and you stumbled across it because of this video, then comment below, let me know what you thought about it. And as always, if you like what you see here, if you like my take on movies, then hit the subscribe button and make sure you hit that bell so you know the next time I release next movie review. So guys, I will see you next time on the channel, but in the meantime, be well, be good to each other, and go watch a movie. Take care, guys.